climate change is no longer the future.
It's completely engulfed, and it is hot.
It's already here.
California is hitting a fearsome milestone.
We're experiencing temperatures, world record-breaking temperatures in the state of California, 130 degrees.
We're seeing bigger wildfires, stronger storms, and devastating droughts.
I'm standing currently 40 feet underwater, or should be. Today, we are advancing a drought emergency.
But both the state and here at CalRecycle, we're doing something about it.
SB 1383 is the biggest change to happen in waste management in over 30 years.
The new Superpollutant Reduction Strategy rules for organics recycling and edible food recovery are part of California's bold effort to fast-track climate progress by reducing the most potent climate superpollutants like landfill methane emissions. Food, fiber, wood, and other organic waste materials make up the largest material types landfilled in California every year. When organic waste material decomposes, it emits methane, a short-lived climate superpollutant 84 times more potent than carbon dioxide, and a major contributor to climate change. California's short-lived climate pollutant reduction law calls on the state's 40 million people, its businesses, and every level of government to reduce landfill methane emissions by achieving a 75% statewide reduction in organic waste disposal by 2025. The law also requires actions to make sure at least 20% of currently disposed edible food is redirected to Californians who don't have enough to eat. The state is encouraging cities and counties to start planning now.
There is a need for more infrastructure to process food waste,
to provide organics collection services to every resident and business in the state, and to connect grocery stores, restaurants, schools, state agencies, and other large food suppliers with local food recovery organizations to feed people, not landfills. In addition to putting more food on the table, the law will reduce pollution and greenhouse gases, the equivalent of taking nearly 2 million cars off the road for a year. By using innovative methods to make and use compost, we'll create things like biofuel and electricity and turn depleted dirt back into nutrient-rich, water-retaining soil. Building the next generation of recycling infrastructure will create about 17,000 green jobs of the future. Ambitious goals, putting California in a much better position to protect the health of our people and our planet.
The really big solution here is taking on the climate crisis.
Because it's still possible, I think, to avoid the worst outcome.